Type 1, the regulator. Value-oriented, disciplined, judgmental. This was a world with no rules and no law. It is easy to understand that as groups became bigger, conflicts could arise out of anything. Not only because the bully of the clan stole your spear, but something even more common. The hunting of big animals involved many people. Then, how do you distribute the meat so that everybody feels they're getting a fair share? There is archaeological evidence from 40,000 years ago of big mammoth bones that show the marks of the cuttings of a flintstone knife that are perfectly equidistant from one another. Anthropologists believe that this is evidence of the existence of a special role that was assigned to an individual in charge of the task, to divide the hunt fairly. We believe they were chosen because they were known for their justice. We believe these are indications of the existence of early regulators. There is evidence that this behavior evolved from a mutation to an area of the brain, the insular cortex, that was originally the center of repugnance. Repugnance or disgust is a very primitive instinct to avoid ingesting toxic, decomposed foods. It is now proven that physical repugnance is connected to moral repugnance in all of us. The biological seed of our own moral conscience was the feeling of disgust against transgressions. Everyone has this mechanism, but types one have it stronger. They came to the world with a visceral rejection against what they consider to be moral impurity or social disorder. They felt a powerful desire to correct others and to do themselves the right thing. They were probably the first sapiens to propose, promote, and enforce rules to regulate social life. The first norms, codes of conduct, rituals, and traditions. This was a huge contribution to keep social peace and maintain the collective together.